everybody. It is Cinnamon Cooney, the Art Sherpa. Welcome to my offering for the hashtag Love Summer Art event, Beachcombing. This fabulous painting can be yours in about an hour. I'm going to show you how, step by step. So grab your art supplies and come on, meet me at this easel right now. We got to go. Wonderful, incredible day to have you in my art studio. I am so excited for what's going on today and what's going to be happening and percolating on YouTube. If you've been following along with me, you know that this is hashtag Love Summer Art Video Art Festival. You're going to be going on Art Safari. You're going to be having a lot of fun. If you're brand new, I'm going to be explaining to you how to use this amazing hashtag to make fabulous art discoveries of other artists. Let's get to the art materials we're gonna need today to make this gorgeous summer inspired painting. All right, now the first most interesting tool is the little cellulose pink sponge. This is just a regular sponge that you would get at your grocery store. They're the less expensive one, and you want something with some nice little bubbly patterns. Brushes, I have an assortment of acrylic brushes. I've got a couple filberts, that's the rounded edge, and these are in an inch to three quarters of an inch range. I've got a bright, which is the square in an inch, and about a half inch, quarter inch. I've got a quarter inch filbert, a detail round, and a teeny tiny detail round. As always, these materials are in the description below. Yeah, I like to hide it there. Right down there where you click the more button, it tells you a whole bunch of stuff with links and helpful information. All right, the art palette. Acrylic paint, heavy bodied. I like to paint with pro. Use the best paint that your budget will allow from a company that cares about your experience. So today we're painting Liquitex, Matisse, and Golden. Today is cadmium, yellow, medium hue, phthalo blue. This is in the green shade, but that doesn't mean it's green. It's still blue. Sometimes these will say red shade, green shade, and you definitely want green shade or you'll get some weird colors with this mixture. I've got some Mars black, some yellow ochre, sometimes called yellow oxide, titanium white, and burnt sienna. And I've got a fun little arrangement here. Cup of water for your brushes, towel to wipe them off. And I have an assortment of colored chalk. And as always, kid chalk is okay. Now, let's get right into this fabulously easy, fun to do. I don't care if you've never painted before. Boy, have you showed up at the right tutorial at the right time. It's like you won the art lottery today. Woohoo! Art Lotto! All right, so I'm going to come up here in my upper right corner. And I'm going to be traveling down here. And we're going to be doing the Jackie Chan, the drunken monkey, which what I mean by that, if you're new, is that we're going to be wandering and jiggity-jaggeting and going back and being all kinds of crazy all the way to the bottom to create an uneven line, because this is going to be our little wave that's rushing. So just about a half inch below that corner, I'm going to make a little mark, okay? And just above this corner, about a half inch up, I'm going to make another little mark. Crazy little trippy things that artists do, but believe it or not, it makes a visual difference. And I'm going to begin the wander. And this is a really fun exercise. It's like a doodle. And I'm telling the story of a little wave that went rushing to the shore, one with a sigh, the other with a roar. That is something I used to hear from my mom all the time when I was a kid. And she had learned that at art camp. Ginger's got some hashtag. Things are just falling off the easel today. She's got some hashtag love summer art, and I will have an iCard going with some playlists and some suggestions, but I really want you guys to work it today and just wander all over art YouTube. We are hundreds plus of artists that are collaborating today for you, creating art that's themed to summer. every medium, every style, every kind of craft or idea or process. I want you to find new artists today and go out and discover what there is, but we're gonna do this right now. I'm gonna pick up my Filbert, 1 inch. Why did I tell you the numbers on this on the little side here? Because this says 22. Because what if you bought a brand besides Creative Mark Ebony Splendor? That's what I'm painting with today. But what if you bought another brand? What would happen? Well, you wouldn't get a size like the same size as this. So if I tell you it's about an inch wide, no matter what company you're looking at, you're going to get the result you want. I'm going to come in here, get it a little bit damp. I'm going to come over and I'm going to make my oceany blue. So I'm going to get a little of my phthalo blue, and look at me, I'm going to add some of this cad yellow to it. Ooh, and you'll see right when it gets into this blue-green range. And I'm going to add just a titch of white. And in this corner, I'm going to come and paint in the corner. Now, sometimes you guys will have a lot of trouble getting a good blend on the canvas, or the canvas isn't coated well and it won't let you paint easily. I really want, especially the new artists, to realize generally what's going wrong in their painting process is not them, that it is either the paint or the canvas or the brush or something with the materials. Because especially in a process like this where I show you the steps, it's very easy to accomplish this. So if you're struggling, like hopefully this will see it's here. If you're not covering the canvas and a lot of white is showing through, you might not have enough paint on the brush. If there's not, it's not covering or the paint is fighting you back, you might be painting with a brand, right, that doesn't give good coverage and it might not have anything to do with you at all, okay? Now, I'm kind of cross-hatching because I'm just trying to get this in, because we're going to do a couple coats of this blue ombre, this blue gradation. But we're going to get this in first, right? Now, I'm going to mix a little more over here, a little more yellow into my blue, right? These are fun shades to get, these water shades. I'm going to come get some white, and I'm going to come and start adding this little white layer. And again, try not to panic here, because there's two coats of this that's going to be happening. Even though this is a super simple painting and anyone can do it and succeed at it, it is still like any other painting. It takes a couple coats. That's another thing that really thwarts new artists, isn't it? Is that they don't know it takes a couple coats to really paint a canvas. So you'll notice I've got some really gorgeous aqua kind of colors happening here, coming in. I really like doing this. I'm not that concerned. I'm sort of painting all everywhere and crazy. I'm not concerned. And the reason I'm not concerned is there's no reason to be concerned. Now I'm going to get just the white and a little bit of my mixture from over here, and I'm going to make a very light color. And I'm going to paint along my little jaggedy line. Now, I know how this all works out. So for me, I'm like, I don't really treat my little line as that sacred. But I understand when you're new, sometimes you're like, I worked really hard to get that line in and it needs to just be the exact same. And that's okay if that's the place you're in emotionally. Art is a journey. The place you're at today is not where you will be tomorrow. You know, today's painting isn't the painting you're going to be doing 10 paintings from now. It's a process. This isn't a talent process. That's not where we're playing, is to find out if we won the talent lottery. We're painting because it's good for our heart, it's good for our spirit, it's good for us as just whole beings, because it's fun to do, because heck, we just want our crayons back. That's why we're doing it. Oh, I love this little wave painting so much. So these are really delicious colors. They really are. They're delicious colors, and I'll blend in here. A lot of times you guys will be like, how do you blend? How do you do it? I paint faster than you. That's really all it is. Acrylics will blend just like oils. They will do many of the things that oils do, but it's about your confidence and your speed to get the effect. However, there are certainly ways to slow down the drying time of your paint. There are chemicals and additives and mediums, slow dry blending medium, definitely slows down the drying time of your paint. On my other wave painting, we talk a little bit about that medium. And if you did the wave painting, you'll sail through this because the colors will all be so easy. And if you do this, you'll sail through the wave painting. So you can have a couple, right? But today I want you to go out and explore. I want you to make playlists. All right, I'm gonna put this in water. And I'm gonna find another filbert about the same size because I'm just painting in my basic stuff. Now, on my sand, I'm gonna do an interesting thing. My bottom color, my first color, is actually gonna be my darkest color. So I'm gonna come and I'm gonna add a little of the burnt sienna to my ochre oxide. I might even grab a little black and gray it out, which I don't normally do in my painting, but for this, I absolutely do. And I'm gonna paint all of this in that sort of tone. Now listen, this isn't Home Depot. We're not painting our walls. So we don't have to have the exact same shade every time we put our brush to the canvas. That's actually not our goal. If sometimes it's just one up lighter, if sometimes it's just one down darker, we don't actually have to worry about that. Our first job when doing a painting is get this tricky thing, the underpainting. The underpainting. It's kind of like, oh, I don't know, like the undergarments, the corset of a painting, you know? It's that understructure that gives everything that nice effect. And the difference between new artists and artists with a little bit of experience is being very comfortable with the fact that it takes a couple layers of paint to get a good painting in. I am really excited about this Love Summer Art Festival we've got going. It has been a real joy. When I came up with the idea, I thought I might be able to get, like, you know, maybe 14 channels or 20 channels between, you know, the friends that I first initially wrote and their friends, right? That's what it would be. I remember when I wrote Clive and I was like, oh, Clive, because I really like Clive. He's like one of my, you guys know Clive. And if you don't, you need to go find out about Clive. He did a great painting. I was like, this would be really fun. And he's like, yeah, I'd really love to collaborate. And we got my mom and we grabbed Secret and we grabbed Deb from Artsology. And I reached out very shyly to Leanne Lafleur from Studio Silver Creek and also to Angela Anderson. Because, I mean, who of us hasn't seen Angela, right? We love her YouTube channel. We love her stuff. I reached out. I get very embarrassed, you know, just contacting other channels, like even if I watch them all the time. So I like reach out to them and they're like, oh yeah, no, we would love to do that. That would be great to collaborate. And I told them about my idea about a hashtag collaboration and they were all about it, which was so exciting. And then Secret put out her shout out and then it went viral. And now there's just so many channels. Now you have a crazy full art festival that's happened. So you just put that hashtag Love Summer Art in your bar there and go bananas. I have seen channels that I've never seen before that are so exciting. I ran into new channels. Fantas Veil, incredible channel, fabulous watercolor artist. Some of the best bilingual content I have seen on YouTube, seriously. You know, crafters, female artists. We got a lady makes fairy sculpted dolls like what you see on Etsy, shows you how to do the eyes and the parts. It's just, we've got how to draw, we've got all that Cricut stuff. I can't really explain the Cricut stuff. Oh, I got too much black. When that happens, just pull it out. Don't worry about it. Because again, underpainting. Don't stress out on the underpainting. You know, so I reached out and I did that. My mom was so excited. She's like, oh, I'm totally in. Because you know how mom's always up for everything. Ginger Cook Live is my mom. And we're just all up for everything. And then all of a sudden, they just started coming in from the cold, coming in from everywhere to our page and participating. And I am going to go make a playlist and probably attach it to this. I hope you do the same. Make playlists of your favorite artists. Again, YouTube is so big, right? So big. You could just not see one of your favorite people ever because the algorithm doesn't show you everybody. This today, this is special. This is my Inspired by Summer drink. And the cool summer cup with the lemon wedge. I just found these. This company doesn't know me. I'm not paid. I just wanted to share it with you because it's special. Winecraft makes these things, and they're flavored. I had one that was vanilla, which I really liked, and I have this one, which is the lemon, and they're slightly sparkling, so it's a little bit champagne-y to celebrate, and not too crazy on the calories, and small portions, and I've been enjoying them, so I'm telling you, because that really felt like summer to me, and I don't really do, I grew up in California, but I don't do gin and juice. That's not happening. We're going to go back. This is dry. Paint that second layer on the blue. I'm sure you'll hear my kids in the background today doing their little kid thing like they do. All right, I'm going to do this again. What we just did, we just do it again. And you're like, "Really? What?" Yep, do it again. Do it again. So, you know, go check it out. Definitely go see what everyone has done. I think that there's some super exciting stuff. Oh, I met an artist from Houston, Shannon Green. Didn't know she was here. I thought it was like the lone YouTuber besides Graveyard Girl in Houston. There's all of these YouTubers in Houston. Claire Stuckey, the Grateful Chicks. There's just like, it's amazing who I've met. People met other YouTubers that they didn't know were out there. Just a big place. All right. So I'm adding this yellow and blue together, and I'm looking for a deep color. You see how nice and, you know, deep that is? And a little more to the blue than the green. I like in the corner. Okay, a little more to the blue than the green, but honestly, it's not that important. You think it would be, but it's just not. Because water, depending on where you are in the world, comes in a lot of really delicious, yummy, fabulous shades that, you know, are a lot of fun. So what do? We keep adding the white and lightening that water up because it's getting closer to the shore. It's lightening. Find your shade. I love looking for my shade that I like. And it may change up from what you did on the bottom, and that's okay, because believe it or not, this stuff layers out. And I'm moving fairly quickly because I'm trying to blend these edges, but it's not important. If I can get into this while it's still wet, just a goal, these are just skills, they're not things to stress you out. If I can get to this space, this edge here between these two paints while it's still wet, and I use a very light, dusted of my brush. If I'm very gentle with my brush and I just dust it, then what will happen is I'll get a soft blended edge. And I really, really like that. And you guys say, "Sherpa, why are you so weird when you paint?" Because I'm having fun, aren't you? You should be having fun. That is the goal. Love that you guys come by the Facebook page. Love that you guys share what you do. I know I'm like having a little trouble keeping up right now. I literally look at everything, still trying to comment, still trying to repost. I'm still trying to keep up. I'm looking at everything. I love it. And I want to see what you find from other people. You can share other people's artwork with me too. Doesn't just have to be my little beachcombing painting here, right? It could be another artist that you found. You're like, "I made fairy eyeballs. That's what I did." Or, "I learned this incredible multimedia technique and it just blew my mind." Or, "I saw a speed paint or a flip through that really inspired me to do something new." Or, "I found a new artist I'm going to collect." We've got incredible boy artists, girl artists. There's like a diversity of artists out there. It's just amazing. You know, there is just an incredible diversity, and it's so exciting to see what it is. We're going to be doing these monthly is the goal. These hashtag collaborations with a theme are going to be monthly. As a viewer, I want to hear in the comments how excited you are about that. How awesome it is to have artists working together as a team to create content for you to watch that we've really thought about and we've really considered that you can be excited about. Now, see how light I'm getting here? I'm getting very light here. And it's okay if you don't have that perfect, that light, that kind of robin eggy, turquoisey little light blue happening here that you see. It's okay if it's not perfect, because we're going to come back with the little foam of the wave, which is one of the funner parts to do. We're going to come back with a little foam once we get our little beach in. And, oh, I love this. This is one of my favorite ones I'm getting to share with you. If a brush is too big and it's giving you grief, guess what? Just because I paint with that size brush doesn't mean you have to paint with that size brush. You can get a different brush. Get a different brush. Any brush you want. Another brush. It's okay. If you have a different shape you're more comfortable with, oh my goodness, you could just do that. Just do that. Oh yeah, I love it. I love it. Looks so good. Putting this back in the water. That went in really well. How are you doing? I want you to do this. It's just art. It's just a painting. Nobody's life is on the line. I'm just taking time for myself. I'm just giving back to myself. I can do this painting and do it again. And do it again until I'm happy. I don't need to get stuck. I don't need to get hung up. I know it's in me. I have to do that too. Don't think that's just for new artists. I have to do that too. I'm on a big canvas for a show back when I had time to show. And I'd be like, really, like, can I do it? Can I do it? Can I do it? That's my own mantra. That's from my studio to you. Do you guys like my flowers? Do you guys see my flowers? This is my tribute to Lisa Vanderpump. I love her. She's so good at flowers. And also that feels like summer to me. Yes, I watch like a lot of housewives. I have a lot of housewife opinions. I have like sayings around my house to the degree that you agree with Bethany Frankel, you are right. If you hate her, I'm sorry. I just love her. She's so crazy. All right, I'm going to put in a little more beach here as my base. Okay, now I'm going to do some interesting stuff here. I'm going to get a little brown. I'm going to get a little gold. This time I'm going to get a little white. That's right. A little white. And I'm going to be a little light with my pressure, okay? And the reason that I am going to be a little light with my pressure and not try to just dig this paint in and cover every little segment of the canvas is on my beach, it pays off to have unevenness, to have deep tones and light tones. Because the sand isn't one thing or another. Now, this wave happens to be rushing in, so I don't have to paint a darker run of sand here. But if I was going to say that this wave was rolling out, I would actually paint the sand much darker here to say that it was wet. Just a little tip, just in case you're like, I really hate incoming waves. I only like them when they're outgoing. I don't know why you'd feel that way, but you might. And this is your painting. I'm just taking you on my journey. I'm just being here to guide you through your journey, through your art experience. See, you notice how I'm, do you notice how I'm getting very, I'm changing up my color tones here. I'm getting a little bit different here. I'm getting a little bit different there. Look, I just grabbed some more burnt sienna. I'm kind of breaking it up just subtly, but it's happening. When we go to sponge, this will really help us. When we go, and you're like, oh, sponging. And you're like, we're not splattering today? We're not splattering? Aww. Well, no. Today we're not splattering because we've splattered a couple of times now. And now we're going to learn some sponging. And hey, maybe while you're out on your art safari, visiting us YouTube artists that work so hard to make, I can't tell you the hundreds of hours I put into these videos. It's shocking. We work so hard to make this for you, to share our art with you. While you're visiting them, maybe you learn another technique for sand. I don't know. That you love. and come back and redo this painting with that technique, how much will you grow as an artist? I don't know. How much will you grow? And even though the event is, you know, going on July, you know, in 2015, right, all this week, 17th through the 20th, even though that's happening, what is this kind of content called? Did you know? Did you know? Did you know? It's called evergreen. It means it's fun to paint a wave in 5 years as it is to paint today, so it never comes down, which means all of our videos will be giving to you forever. Mm-hmm. You will discover people you adore. You will find artists you didn't know about. Big and small channels are involved. And if you are a channel and you happen to be watching and you somehow missed our crazy call-outs, you know, message me and ask about joining the group because we're going to be doing it monthly. We think this is good. Ooh, I got too much white there. We think this is good for us artists to be doing this. I've also noticed there's been a real outcry among the YouTube artists, interestingly enough, to have their own category on YouTube. And I wonder what you, the viewers, think about that. Do you think that it would be good to have an art category, an art and craft category on YouTube? Because we're not really style and we're kind of how-to, but that doesn't really, I mean, some of the channels, they don't really tell you how, they just share with you their process. They just share with you your art and they're not necessarily education. Maybe we do need our own category. Hashtag Art Army YouTube or YouTube Art Army. That's it. YouTube Art Army. Hashtag give artists our own category. I like it. Really threw a lot of the artists with the hashtagging thing. They're like, hashtagging! Don't know what you mean by hashtagging. All right, so the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm actually going to sponge. Check to see that your paint is dry. A clue that your acrylic paint is dry is that it stops being shiny. Another clue. Sherpa tip. There is a thing that happens in acrylic paint. We refer to it as color shift. The pro paints have less color shift than the lower brands of paint. And what color shift means is it gets a lot darker. How can you fix color shift? Varnish. And there's videos for that. There's a video in my little Art Sherpa collection for that, and there's videos out on YouTube for that. Varnish will help fix your color shift. Just saying. All right, so I'm gonna pull out a little bit of white paint. I'm gonna dab it right here at this little spot. I don't know if you've ever done this with kids or with somebody. And I get this sort of pattern on here. And then out here in this little wave area, I'm gonna create this little, I'm gonna try to avoid showing the squareness of the sponge, and to do that, whoop. That's okay, that will paint out. These things happen. Look at me not being worried about that. I'm not even worried about that. Okay, and I'm pressing in. And I'm breaking up these little patterns. I know that I've got some stuff that's going to be happening that will help me. So I'm not too freaked out about any of this. That will be the big difference between you and me, is I am not freaked out. When you are, take a sippy sippy of whatever your delicious beverage is. Little bite of whatever yummy snack you have decided to accomplish, put with your day. If you're with friends, support each other. If you're painting this in a group, don't let your friend melt down and trash their art any more than you would let them say they were ugly and fat. Don't let your friend do it. Talk bad about their art. They're talking bad about themselves. You guys, don't talk bad about yourselves. No point in doing it. Doesn't help nothing. See how that creates this sort of little foamy texture? It's a lot of fun to do. It helps me learn to break up patterns because the sponge itself wants to make a pattern. So I have to turn it. I have to move it around. It's just another tool. And then I'm going to kind of get some little white spots out here. Helps me break up the pattern. A lot of what I'm doing here is observing how my art tool is interacting with my canvas and deciding, do I need more paint? No. What do I need here? What's needed here? And then just adjusting for that. So I'm gonna get, I think, maybe this one. I'm gonna get this little brush and I'm gonna get some just white. Oh no, actually I think, I just put the white down because I want to sponge the other side first. I think that's gonna give us the best result. I did it the other way the other time, but then I realized I have a lot of control that may not be something that you feel like you have control over. So I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna get some of this and some white. And I'll dab over here, get a little brown. And I'm gonna come start dabbing my beach. And you can see why I thought maybe we're gonna use the wave itself to hide some of your integration of sponging. So I've got some white. I did grab some little burnt sienna. That helps. Sometimes you might grab a little of your black. You gotta do it slowly, kind of see what's happening with your sponge. These are cheap enough and easy enough to wash out where you don't have to worry too much about what's going on. And you can always, like, you know, dab dab. See, I dab dab there. It's very helpful to do that. And we're gonna come and do shades and halyus and just sand up our beach. Shells and rocks and things are being found here, and we're just having a lovely time. This is the beach. I really wish I was on vacation. I mean, I wish I had Turks and Caicos money. I would love to have Turks and Caicos money. Glad I have VidCon money. Going to VidCon. But I would love to be. See, I got some more gold there. Look how that looks. And then, but I got patterns going. So then I got to come back and be like, oh no, pattern. Go away. Go away. I will not put up with you. You know, it'd be nice to have, you know, the French Caymans or wherever, somewhere gorgeous with some dream beach tiapoo. I watch a lot of Travel Channel. I always, you know what I follow on Twitter? I follow Contiki. Oh my god, and I post to them all the time. That would make a good painting. I'm kind of hoping that they'll send me somewhere to show you guys how to paint like some fabulous travel destination. World wishing. Wouldn't that be great to take Heart Party on the road? To go on the road with Heart Party and paint fabulous locations. I think it'd be awesome. I'm willing to go. I'm willing to go. I'm getting just my yellow ochre here, dabbing it on my sponge. And just this brighter kind of gold color. And you'll notice I haven't washed my sponge during any of this process, and I may put out some more yellow ochre. I haven't washed my sponge during any of this process. Just beaching away. Beachcombing. Beach, are you beachcombing? Are you dreaming of the beach? Even if you can't afford the beach like me, are you dreaming of the beach? You can paint it. What do I always say? Being an artist is like being rich. If you can dream it, you can have it. All right, making those views out my windows. These are my little windows. What do I want to look at today? You paint enough, you can put these things up and down seasonally. My mom and I do that. It just trips people out. We have like the holiday paintings. We have the seasonal paintings. There's paintings that are up only in winter. I have a good friend, Matt Adams, and he's going to have to do that because his art collection has gotten so big. He's going to start needing to put it out. Like, I don't know, like, this is the spring collection and you can see it for 3 months when you visit his house. And then there'll be the winter collection that you could see when you visit his house because he has that much art. He's a crazy amount of art, like hundreds and hundreds of pieces. We'll value art still. We do. Now, I'm going to get some white and dab it on here and kind of really mix it into my sponge. See? I'm gonna add that to this here because I wanna just keep layering everything up. Just layering it up. The technique, the win on this when you blow people away is when you just give yourself the time to make yourself happy with it. to find the level of sponginess that says, oh, I've got a beach. And remember, what do? We back up. Ooh, that little bit right there, that little bit, I love that. That worked out really well. See, stuff happens for me too, where it's like, it's, you know, what did the master say? Happy accidents. And why do I say master? Because definitively, guess what? 30,000 paintings, whole bunch of qualifications. A lot of artists are coming around to that reality now. Look at that beach. Now, another little trick I might do is I might grab some of this black. Now, I'm not going to get too crazy with it. I'm going to move around my sponge, get some of this white, work it into here, get this soft gray. See, I'm making these little bits, right? Still needs to be lighter than that, though. You'll see it happen here before you even put it here. Beachcombing, painting a beach, beachcombing, painting a beach, so happy. So fun to just sing and paint. I mean, I'm not trying to be on Idol. I don't want to be on that show. I have no illusions. I just think singing is a sign of happiness and you should do it, whether you're good at it or not. Just, that's what I believe. You have a song in your heart, you should sing it. If you have a poem, write it. If you have a painting, paint it. World needs more creative people. Look at that. Ooh, I did it. I did it. I painted a beach. Oh, I did it. I did it. I painted the beach. Do you feel good? Pat yourselves on the back. That was pretty awesome. It's a good time to breathe now. It's a good time to let it go. All right. It's a good time to sippy sippy, as Graveyard Girl says. She's a fellow Texan. Does not. She's some crafty stuff, but she doesn't really do art, and she's not in our collaboration, so I don't know if I'm mentioning her. Probably just because she's awesome and local. I always put my lemon to the side. It's nice. All right. Now, earlier I'd put this little sort of filbert here with just white on it, the filbert. It's like a half-inch filbert. You could do this with a half-inch bright. If you had one of my all-purpose angle brushes, you could do that. Any brush will really work. I'm just going to load this with some just white. And I'm going to look for this interesting sort of line that my sponging created. And I'm going to, hopefully you can see this on the up-close cam. Yeah, it looks like you can. Okay. I'm making these little sort of little dashes, these sort of vertical, kind of moving them around. This is a little wave. It's coming in. This is a little wave. A little whitewash. There's something that's happening. The wind is blowing. But it's a beautiful breeze at my beach. There's a cabana boy. He's bringing me one of these drinks. I'm relaxing. I hate to say it, but I may be on vacation without my kids. I love my kids, but 10 years, I have never been on vacation without my kids. Never been anywhere overnight without them. VidCon will be my very first time to leave my kids with someone else and go on a trip. My daughter's 10. I feel a little bit like a shut-in, you know? Now, am I going to connect that wave up? I could, but I'm not. And you're like, you're not? I'm like, no, I'm not. I might do another little wave here, though. Trickily that I am. I might add a little bit there, but I'm going to break the line, and I'm going to do that for artistic reasons because I'm playing. Guess what? This doesn't just have to be, I'll show you at the end. It does not just have to be a horizontal. It can be a vertical. Loading up with more white paint. You can always grab a little of the yellow if you want to add to it. Just a hint. Okay. Now I'm going to come along this edge. I'm going to get out of the way so you can see this on the cam, and I'm going to make my foam. It's a really easy painting. super fun. It's gorgeous. You will love hanging it. You would have bought it if you saw it at an art fair. But it's better than that because you made it. That's what I'm going to say to you. Share this with me on Facebook and tell me what your art safari was like. Your assignment is to find an artist you didn't know about that you love. That's my assignment to you. That's my gift to you. That's my whole plan for this, is to just help us meet each other, the artists and the viewers, just to help us meet each other. Because it's so hard to do. Help us meet each other. Oh, wow. Look at that. Do you start to feel it? It's like magic, right? I feel like a magic noise should be inserted here. My husband loves to insert that folly, all those great noises and craziness. Dude, I think I heard something that was weird. I get alone in the studio and I talk to myself. My kids are always like, Mom, you're doing it. You're talking to yourself again. Because I will think about an episode. I'll think about something I want to do and then I'll just start talking like you guys are here now. My children think that I have gone mental. It could be right. I'm okay with being mental. I did a lot of years being sane and skinny and together. And I didn't like those years. I liked all the years when I was young, when I was like my crazy self. And when I like came to that realization, you know how when you get to a certain place in life and you realize, I like me the way I am. I just like me. Not everybody has to like me. I just like me the way I am. I trust my heart. I know my spirit. I'm a good person. And I like me. That's a great place to get. All right. Now I'm going to come back with even a little more paint. And this time I really want you to see how thick that is. I'm going to come in here and this is thick. Now this is something I'm going to do. You can do it or not do it. Okay? Do it or not do it. And I'm going to add some of this thick paint, which hopefully this is catching. This is called impasto. When you see an artist paint with very thick paint, oil painters do this because they're crazy. Guys, your paint doesn't dry. It's not designed for that. It's designed for thin glazing techniques. But you come in and you put this thick paint in. Oil painters everywhere are going to be like jumping me. You don't know what you're saying. I'm like, yeah, I do. Exactly what I'm saying. Got some white here. Now, of the whites, golden has my very favorite white, if it matters. Sometimes when you're looking at Liquitex or Matisse or golden, you're really looking at the same price range. I like their white the best. They may not have won my paint to paint test, but I do like their white the best, which is why you see it a lot. So see, I'm putting all this little texture in. Can you see that texture? I'm even going to come here and see if I can zoom this in. All right, just for a second. Do you guys see that? Some texture that I'm doing. And you can do that with heavy bodied paint. All right, I'll zoom it back out. I just wanted you to be able to see it. Not really good at zooming. Where is that good to you? I think that's good to me. So that's what I'm doing, using up this paint. Putting this thick amount. And this is the difference between a heavy bodied paint and a soft bodied, is the soft bodied will self level and probably run down a vertical canvas. The heavy bodied paint will hold that texture. Add gel to it, and then there you go, right? Clive says something. Oh, Bob's your uncle. Meanwhile, in Wales, I love that we're having a real time collaboration with somebody that is that far away. Do you guys love this? Do you like the texture that I'm sharing with you that you can do here? This is just something I can show you that you might not have thought of, that you might not have known about. All right, I feel like I've given a very painterly, expressive little way of rushing in and put this in water. which, by the way, is lazy artist brush care, because you're really not supposed to. You're supposed to, like, rinse them out and, like, store them flat and then wash and condition them. And because otherwise all the paint cracks off the handle, and everything that happens in my brushes happens, which is why I buy Creative Mark from Jerry's Artarama. I can get a really expensive brush for a couple bucks on sale. I don't have to be so upset. In no way are they my sponsor at all. They don't even talk to me. They don't know me. They got their own channel with their own info. This is just actually my opinion. Now, I'm going to get that little half inch bright I mentioned. You know? Right? And I'm going to come and I'm going to get a little of my black over to my yellow ochre. Got a little crazy there with it. Now I've got the color. I love finding the color. You ever notice I do the twist to get paint off the heel of my brush? I bet you guys get paint on the heel of your brush. You're like, how do I get this off? I twist and pull, and then I reload it. And I'm going to come along my little wave edge here. With this darker color. Very carefully, I'm not trying to pick up the white, and you may have to let yours dry. If you're picking up the white and it's going just super, super gray on you and you're not liking it, let it dry. I've just done this enough, I don't have to. So we'll pretend I let it dry. You let yours dry and marvel at my braveness. Why am I doing this, guys? Because the shadow, here's Sherpa tip. I don't care what waves you're painting on a beach, what waves you're painting crashing over, one of the biggest mistakes new artists make is not putting a shadow under that foam. That little wave of foam rushing in, that line, always has a shadow. Take a second, sit at a beach if you're lucky enough to be able to, and look at it. Watch a movie. It's what it does. And it happens to every new artist I ever run into. It's the thing they don't see. That's all it is. The thing they don't see. As new artists, there's things we don't see. Doesn't mean we're not talented. Just means we're not what's called developed. Another thing I'm doing here is sort of scrambling dry brushing. I don't have a lot of paint on my brush. All right. That's what I'm doing. I'm scrambling the dry brush. Easy to do. This isn't hard. Not a lot of moisture on my brush. So the paint is coming off in a thin, kind of glazy coat. You get white on there, let it dry, or do what I'm doing. Don't. I just want to get through this lesson for you guys so you can get on to the next YouTube channel. Making playlists. When you guys, can you do me a favor? When you find people that you love, when you find projects that you love, could you do me the favor of hashtagging it lovesummerart on your social media and all the places that you share it? Because that will really help that gain traction. I know you know, you can't pay us. You can't really share with us always, you know, your appreciation. But this is a way that you can show us your appreciation by sharing it with the hashtag everywhere you can, by putting it in playlists. Oh, YouTube loves when we get in playlists. Just loves it. Thinks we're so cool. Make playlists from your Love Summer Art. Make playlists from every hashtag. Share those artists on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook. Hashtag Love Summer Art. Look at that. We're nearly done. Woo! It's so special. It's just lovely being us. All right, now the detail brushes. Had a little teeny tiny one. There it is. I like starfish on my beach. You might like sand dollars. And I like to have a couple pebbles and shells. And so how I do that is first I get a little of my burnt sienna and a little of my black. And I make a darker kind of brown. I could also just use burnt umber, but I didn't put any out. I didn't feel like using it. And I'm going to draw starfish and a starfish. Yeah, that's close, so you can see what I'm doing. And you're like, but what if I can't draw a starfish? Stencil, trace, drawing, don't let drawing be the obstacle to you enjoying what you're doing. And honestly, I'm not that great at drawing starfishes. It's just the truth. I really worked on this. You'll see me. It'll take me a minute to work it out. And it can take you a minute to work it out. And is that a big deal? No. That is not a big deal. It's not important how long it takes. You could put Patrick on here, you know, if you wanted to impress your kid, paint a pink one. Blow their mind. They'll be like, what? What? How did you know? I'm going to put another little starfish a little bit lower diagonally. And this one might be smaller. Smaller starfish. Again, like I said, not brilliant at drawing starfish. Freehand with paint. It's not my big skill. So look at me not freaking out. Why? Because I actually know by the time the thing's all painted in, it works out. And I've done this more than one time in my life. You see, you knew. You're like, it could go so bad. Nah, nothing will explode. Just paint. It will dry, and you will paint over it. You guys get caught up in stuff. I get so many, my moons. My moon is not a C. So paint it out. Get a general C. Move on. Finish the painting. Completion is perfection. Not that there's anything wrong with being perfectionist. Perfectionist is a skill. I admire perfectionists, but it is the completion of a painting that gets you moving forward in your art skills. Gets you going. Gets you going. So excited about VidCon. First trip away from the kids. So I have those in, right? Next thing I'm doing, I'm going to do something kind of crazy here. You're going to be like, what are you doing? I'm going to get a little white, but I'm going to make a very, very, very dark color. Got a little brown in it. This is a very, very dark color. And I'm going to make some pebbles and some stones, okay? And I'm going to make a little outline here. So I'm going to say I've got a little stone here. There's a little rock here. Rock. Ooh, I'm going to make a shell shape, which is that little half circle with the two sides, like a roundy triangle with the little wings. I'm going to make a little shell because I like shells on my beach. Beachcombing. That's why I named it Beachcombing. The idea is that I'm looking for nummy bits of things to pick up. Some of my little dots are very small and some are bigger. Why is that? Because there's little bits of things. Little wonderful discovery things. You could put little birds' feet running down here. Yes, you could. Little birds' feet. Anything could be on your beach. If you're very good at painting, children's footprints running down the beach. So cute. So adorable. Okay. I'll put another little shell because I feel like I want another little shell. Don't you want another little shell? This one's a little bigger. This one's a little bigger. Okay. And it has the little wings. And then I'm going to give it a little friend because I like to have three sometimes. Odd numbers of things, even though I have two starfish. Just trust me, I've made them odd with other little objects that I've placed. And just, all right. So I put those there and I rinse my brush. I've got this gray color. I'm going to bring it over to my yellow ochre. I'm going to get that color and come right into my white, making a light gray color with this yellow tinge to it. Then, what am I going to do? Add a highlight while leaving the shadow to remain. Look at that. Not the shells, though. Uh-uh. Just the rocks. Just the rocks. Just the rocks. And you may have to knock the rocks back if the shadow's too deep. And that's what I'm doing. I'm doing this little dab. Just a little bit of it showing. Not a lot. The shell's up. All right, I want you to take some of this color that you made, get maybe a little more yellow. You're gonna come and you're gonna just leaving some of the brown showing, and your brush pressure should be very, very light. You're gonna paint a lighter highlight around your starfish. Just, do you see that? Not too different from the fox. You can paint a lighter highlight around your starfish. Letting some of the dark show through. You might pick up those starfish. You might not. You might decide, no, they're animals. I don't want to pick them up. They're still alive. The waves might come pick them, take them back out to the ocean where they live. I'll leave it alone. And then you want to paint a little more highlight at the top of the starfish. Slightly lighter. Little bit out the arms, just to show that they've got that shape, because they're quite three-dimensional, right? The three-dimensional beings, they're alive. They have starfish dreams, starfish hopes and dreams. So you might just walk by them and not pick them up. And then I'm gonna go and get my little beachy gray color that we've been working. Maybe a little darker. Pull it out. I like to do my pull and twist to load my brush, pull and twist. And I'm going to make a shadow. And I need a slightly darker shadow than that, I think. I think I'm gonna get much darker. Make a little shadow right here and line. Yeah, like the wave has a shadow. Just on this backside of starfish. Just on the backside. That's my tip. Just the backside. Just like the wave's front. Just this. Not these. Just this. You need more water? Get more water. Get better flow. Like Parappa the Rapper. Oh, that's an old game, isn't it? It's the only game that I was like better. Well, I was pretty good at Soul Calibur. My husband's a pretty good gamer, as he should be, considering he makes games. Not anymore. Now he makes YouTube channel shows. Look at that. Do you feel like you could just pick your starfish up? Let's look at those. They're looking pretty good. They're a little dark still. I want them a little golder. Right? And so that's what I want you to look for, is what would you change? How would you change it? I want my starfish to be a little golder. At least one of them. So I'm going to come back with like my yellow ochre paint, and I'm going to just make sure he's just a little bit more that. A little bit. Just a titch. I still want to see him, but I just want him to be a little more. Just a little more. And you're always adjusting when you're painting. I have strong feelings about these little creatures that have washed up from away. That's a quite light, add a lot of white to my yellow ochre to get that color right there. See? Make adjustments. It happens to me too. I just don't freeze. I just go, oh, I just lighten it up. You guys see something, your art brain says, I'd like to change that. You guys panic because you don't have faith in yourselves yet that you can change what you need to change. That's all it is. Let's put in our shells. So I'm going to make a mid-gray, right? I'm going to make a mid-gray. I'm wasteful in making it, but I'm going to make a mid-gray. I'm actually going to want that. It's too dark. And a gray. All right. Here we go. There we go. That's the gray I want. It's quite light, actually. That's the gray I'm looking for. And I'm going to just very carefully paint my little shell. Paint my little shell. Paint my little shell. See the little shells? You see them? See my little shells? I'm gonna take that darker color that I first made that I didn't love. Yeah. See? Happy accidents. I'll make some little lines on the shells because I like them to have lines. Lines. Make sure they got some dark sand under them. I'm gonna do that too a little bit with these things. I've got that dark sand color and I'm just making sure they're casting shadows. Make sure things in your painting cast shadows. Stuff casts shadows. And shadows have dimensions. Sometimes they're dark, 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 and then they have a lighter thing like what we have at the waves. See how we've come and added the shadow color from the wave to the stones where they have the darker shadow and it just makes them feel more real and grounded? That's what it does. Oh my goodness. Let's back up. Let's witness it. Dude, do we approve? Do we love our beach? Did we go beach combing? Did we do it? Oh. Did it. We did it. And guys, we did it in about an hour like we always do, which has been pretty great that we're getting it there. All right, listen. What's your job right now? Your job is to go out and watch some other artists. Put hashtag lovesummerart in your search bar and just go bananas. If you like them, please comment, please subscribe, please like it, share it, post it, use the hashtag, get it out there, make a playlist of your favorite art. Be sure and come by the Facebook page or Instagram or Twitter or wherever you want to interact with me and share your painting, share your adventure. I'd love to hear down here what this has been like for you. Has this been great? Was this an exciting thing that we've all done? Is this worth the effort? Because if you guys like it, we will keep doing it. We'll keep bringing it to you. We'll keep taking it out there. I want to see you and you at the easel really soon. Bye-bye.
Oh, hey everybody, I forgot to tell you that this could also be vertical. I think I mentioned it in the video and I then didn't show you. That kind of stuff happens all the time because like there's craziness always going on in the background and I forget what I'm doing or I hear some noise and I gotta decide is it like a mommy emergency or a child care kind of thing. So I never know how it's gonna be. Just to point this out to you in our little end card here, guess what? Makes a good vertical too. You can do this vertical or horizontal. I just wanted to show you that. I don't know how to show you that in the end card. How you been? How you doing? Go watch another video. Why are you still here? You're still here. You're always still here, and I love you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your comments and your time and being here in my end card. Don't worry, if you're going to sing, nothing happens. No sound for you. No. This time, I just show you vertical and horizontal. That's all you do.